of YouTube. So here, this is the paper gasket. That was the old gasket that was taken out. It was taken out, and then this gasket here is the wrong one, because this one, this gasket here, has no gasket in the suction pipe. Which this one here is correct. That's the right gasket there. And see to it that the holes are aligned. If the holes are aligned, then that's the correct gasket we have. Especially this one here. That's for the suction pipe tube. And here. Yeah. Hasta la vista, yeah. See you, see you. So everything is in order here. I moved the camshaft, and you can see that it is good. It's moving. So the crankshaft is not seized. So it's still good. It's good. So guys, every bolt that you put in, put oil on it, so the bolt will not overheat during the positioning and the tightening. So, oil on it.
All good.
All good, yeah. So, see here, this is the bolt. Just dip with oil. All done. So this is how you install the sump and together with the bolts. You have to dip with oil so it will not overheat for some reasons. Okay. This long bolt here, also dip with oil. This is how, again, the reason for that, you're dipping with oil so the bolt will not overheat
once you're tightening it down. And tightening down, you have to have like a first start in the middle and then move your way outwards. You tighten it, move your way outwards.
So tighten it. So actually, it's on my own decision. We put a washer here, put the washer just to have a room
clearance on the inside. As you can, you have the room, a little bit of room on the bolts inside.
Yeah, this is the last bolt, and there is washer as well. I put it on. And once the bolts, all bolts are inside,
then you're gonna push up. Okay. Okay. That's it.
And then we're gonna tighten that by hand. We're gonna tighten it by hand.
And move it upwards. Like that here. Like here.
And we're gonna use swivel on this side here because it's too difficult. It's too cold position. Okay.
It's on the very corner and very impossible to tighten it without using the swivel.
That's it. And we have the final blow. Yes, we have here. Balance, we're using guns, but this is controlled. Tightening is controlled tightening,
not like only few taps. three taps. You have to control it. And then we tighten it all around. We're gonna be doing all around now. And then our final loop will retorque 30 Newton meter. You should put this like a calibrate, because sometimes didn't work. So that works. Okay. You can hear the clicking sounds.
Yeah.
gasket. It's dirty. Double check. It's actually 25 to 30 meter. This is triple check, guys. Sure, you don't miss anything here. Thank you. Okay guys, so this is the reason why there is an excessive oil leak here, because the thread here inside is fucked. This is the reason why the heavy oil leak was from here, because the thread is fucked, and then they just put it back on without tapping it. And then what we're doing is just we tap the thread, inner thread, so we create our own thread and even create our own size of bolt. Okay, so this is 1.5 12 by 1.5 size of thread tapping dice, and this is the result. And then just put it in here. Now this is very risky when you're doing this job, because if you are like doing this job and then you don't know what's going on, so this is now what we're doing here. This is the reason what's the story is, because the thread is fucked here, and then I don't know, so the guys just put them back in without any doing the retread or tap dice, whatever should be tapping dice. So that will be good, and it won't leak anymore. So that's gonna tighten down. And we will see if this goes 30 newton meter. So that is done. Like you know, so once you get in, and that is tight, 20 newton meter, more or less, 25. Okay, that is tight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, it's done. Now we put back, change this one, we change the sensor, oil level sensor. Okay, double check everything in. Okay, and we're gonna repeal the oil, about 17 liters, and the oil drain plug markings still on the mark line, so we can repeal.